Welcome and thank you for joining us. I'm Sanya Mal, your host for the evening. Welcome to Innovative Possibilities. This is a series that has been put together under Design Circle to have conversations around design, innovations that are happening in the world of design, and the future of design. Powered by a collaboration between HP and Creative Gaga, it is an initiative to make print-related knowledge accessible to everybody. Today, we are joined by industry experts from the field of design and print to understand how design has become a powerful tool and the innovative possibilities both in the fields of print and design that can strategically rise to meet unique challenges. Before we begin, I would like to tell you a little bit about how the session is going to pan out. First, we have our industry experts, Mr. Anthony Lopez and Mr. Ashok Power, who will give us their presentations. After their presentations, we are going to open up the floor for questions. You can put in your questions in the chat box below and we can take them up at the end of the session. Now on to the speakers. First, let me introduce to you Mr. Anthony Lopez. Anthony Lopez is a designer and founder of Lopez Design, established in 1997 as a multidisciplinary communications and branding firm. With a master's in design from NID, he is a genuine believer that doing greater good is the right path. Anthony has steered Lopez Design to be a world-recognized firm, garnering accolades both nationally and internationally. Anthony's ambidextrous methodology and dogged pursuit of excellence and integrity has gotten him many accolades. A popular speaker, Anthony has given talks at national and international conferences, the Coalition, Curious Design Yatra, and the Sri Lanka Design Festival. He's also spoken at Design Into Design Forum, the ACA Design Festival at Mauritius, and HD Bandfest at Kathmandu. He's also a regular teacher at NID and was selected as a graphic design representative from India for the World Skill Competition in 2017. Today, Anthony will share several client case studies across corporate, government, and NGO projects to showcase his thought process and strategic use of design. I'm going to now give the floor to Mr. Lopez.
Thank you, Sanya, for that great introduction and very kind of you to read it all out. And I was not very much aware that you had this very long version of introduction about me, but thank you so much. So I'm going to take you on a journey, and that journey is my life journey in context to how I took this journey in the field of design across many, many years, right? Like since early days of my life. And so that's one part. And the other part is what I'm going to do is this presentation is going to be delivered slightly differently from what you're used to, because I'm going to shift planes from one moment to the other, right? But I will indicate them to you when I'm shifting planes. There's a lot of talk going to happen from my end, and I hope it makes some sense to you. I will also demonstrate how all this talk results in work which we deliver. And eventually, I'll put the challenge up to all of us in context to can we impact change? You know. So I'm going to share my screen now. Hi, can somebody tell me if you can see my screen?
Yes, your screen is
visible. Yes, we do. Yeah.
I'm just trying to shift this just a second. So I'm also making another assumption that a large part of my audience are young people who are highly energetic, excited about taking on the future. And hopefully, basically, I should bring in some amount of influence if I can, in context to how they could manage it in their world. So this is a slide which you're going to see reasonably often. It's a link, as you can read. So I'm literally asking you to blink in terms of in your mind, right? So I'm shifting topics. That's when you see the slide. So these two dogs basically came into our lives about 2 years back, just before COVID, you know, and they became our life as puppies. So we basically adopted them from the streets of Delhi, and they became, you know, a change in our life. And why I say change in our life, because of course as puppies, it was great to have little puppies around. But very soon I realized that in my comfort zone of organized life at our home, everything was organized, everything was neat and clean. These puppies came and started shitting all over the place and peeing and crying and howling, and we just could not manage them, right? At the same time, there was great love for them. And I had to actually change my persona to be able to deal with these people who were shitting all over the place and peeing all over the place, right? And the smell and everything put together. And it literally brought this change in my life.
My slides are not moving.
I wonder why. Can you see my desktop?
We can still see the haze.
Now? Yeah. So, blink.
Yes.
Okay, there we go. Thank you. So, very quickly, blink is when I'm shifting topics. These are the two puppies whom we adopted off the streets, and they became our life. We fell in love with them instantly, but they became a big change in our life because we had to handle all the shit that came with them. Right? And today they are big boys. Yeah, this is just a few months into the COVID, and Zach and Cody, they're still mischievous, they still mess around. But they are part of my life. But this is an example that, which I put forward in most of my presentations now, that can we bring more of such Zach and Cody's into our life more frequently, right? Because we need to bring in that change for us to perceive the world in a different manner. And that's what happened to me with context to these two dogs. Shifting topics, blink. So little about Lopez design, and I'll move quickly on this one. So we are a multidisciplinary firm, you know, which is seeding transformational interventions that create authentic customer experience to drive sustainable business growth. So whatever we do is always seeded into long-term implication. Right? So we design environments, ecosystems, you know, and we rooted deep in understanding of India's complexity and diversity. This is a subject which is very dear to me. We're talking about global design experiences, which we apply over to everything what we do, because we compete in a global environment. For me, it is very critical that the why of what you do is more important than what we do. This is what our studio looks like. So I heavily invested in creating a studio and environment which would so-called express the ethos and support the ethos. I'll speak a little bit more about it. And this is what it looks like. And most of you are welcome. All of you are welcome. But there's a wall in the studio, which basically we have embedded in concrete, and it says we are all born with genius. Yeah. So it's like a fairy old godmother, you know. But what happens in life is that we stop listening to our inner voice, and we no longer have access to this extraordinary ability to create poetry. And these are the words of Milton Glaser. I'm blinking again. So coming back to We Are All Born With Genius again, this is my firm belief that there is greatness lying in each one of us. Every individual has that greatness. But because of society, because of the way we are born, with the limitations, without limitations, whatever it is, that something goes wrong along the way and we have not been able to bring the best out of us. And I think if we start getting aware of this particular concept, then I think there is a chance of doing that all over again for any individual once they realize that they have the potential in them. So I'm trying to bring in some context to reimagining design. And the context is basically through India. So India has its own ingredients. Therefore, its output needs to be unique to itself and let the world love for what it is. It's very important that the world loves us for who we are. And like the Japanese have done it for themselves and the Europeans have done it, then the US is doing like that for themselves. And I think now it's high time that we express ourselves and everything comes through us for who we are. I also feel that design is the most misunderstood among us converted people, right? And I'm assuming that most people in this presentation are people who understand design. What I think is design is a powerful and strategic tool if comprehended and used appropriately. So here I'm using the word strategy not in context to application of only in business, but in terms of how design can be applied so that it creates the necessary impact. Blinking once again. So I've got about three tenets which I normally speak about, and this becomes the basis of my entire presentation and discourse. Yeah. And one of the influences of this, which I can now point out to, is you all know Harari. And I think a lot of you all must have read his book, very famous and popular book, 21 Lessons for the 21st Century. What makes it a little bit interesting is that Yuval Noah is a historian, right? So he looks at history, and then here he has the audacity to predict the future by looking at the history, right? And that's what's interesting and exciting for me, you know, that our past can showcase how we will perform in the future, right? And I think he does a pretty decent job. So he says morality doesn't mean following divine commands. It means reducing suffering. Hence, in order to deliver morality, you don't need to believe in any mythical story. You just need to develop a deeper appreciation of suffering. And this is again where I perfectly align with a statement like this, that we need to be really, really aligned to the aspect of suffering, because that's what problem solving is about. How do you reduce suffering? How do you make things better for us? Right? And us would mean beyond us as human beings. So again, Yuval makes a statement, and I think it's a very relevant statement, that humans were far better at inventing tools than using them. We all know that future is big data, the machine learning and biosciences, right? And we are already immersed in that world of big data, machine learning and biosciences. It's constantly affecting us in every way, and it's affecting. But we also know that as individuals, we'll be blindsided, you know, and subsequently we'll have less control of our decisions and the way things move forward in life, right? Because these technologies will overbearingly come and utilize our ability to comprehend, to make good decisions, etc. It'll start clouding us in many, many ways. And we already see them as tools which firms like Amazon, Google, all these people are using tools that we understand, and we know that there are biases entering into these things. And by the time basically we manage to comprehend this, I mean, the world would have moved on. So this is the same thing which I was saying, is powerful people who own these tools will manipulate it many ways. So while manipulation can happen knowingly or unknowingly, we are assuming business people always are doing business for profit, right? And thereby they may ignore certain finer things in order to make better profit or compete and become the topmost in the value chain. So I say that unless a great number of us get together and say, let's do the right thing. And this is, again, a statement which hits us very deep in context to morality, in terms of, okay, as designers, you know, do I have the ability to be able to even make a statement like this, right? In context to the clients we advise or the work we do, and everything that emerges through us as creators. Uh, So the other thing we also are aware of, I think especially the generation which has seen the different progressions in the recent times, where we know that change is happening at a pace far at such a high pace that it is difficult for us to predict the outcome. So, I mean, one thing which you can easily talk about is the social media, right? And the outcomes of the evils of social media, which is emerging, and now we are very much aware of it. And yet there are no proper so-called policies and laws in place which allows this so-called the negative effects of social media to be controlled in a manner which will not drag people into the so-called black hole of binging, which is only one component of it, but other components in context to social behaviors, groupism, etc. what happens because of technology moving at such a fast pace. And when technology moves at such a fast pace, there are new inventions and new ways of doing things or new ways of connecting with people. And everything has a pro and a con part of it, right? And by the time policy catches up, sometimes it's too late. And thereby, basically, as designers and as people and as creators, we need to be highly agile and adaptable. So how do you comprehend something which is so complex? So we typically get into the whole business of doing anything because there's a medium which we need to provide for, right? In terms of design, for in terms of communication or branding or whatever it is. And yet, basically, I think what the demand is for us, that while we are design and adaptable to the medium in concern, we also need to be aware of what it does to people and cognizant about that. And then lastly, basically, as designers, we need to become other champions. So we need superheroes as designers. And I think young designers, if they aim early to become superheroes with solid foundations, with solid greatness lying within them, then you can become champions. And when you become champions, then you shape a lot of things. You can bring about change. And here we just put four pictures of champions in their own respective fields, right? Looking again. So here's a short introduction about myself. So my name is Anthony Lopez. And I do not know how many of you recognize this person, but he's Amitabh Bachchan from the film Amar Akbar Anthony. And so when most people, when they hear my name, Anthony Lopez, without seeing me, they think I'm important. And when they see me, they think I'm Goan. Aap Goa ke honge? And when they hear me, most secretaries on the phone, they say Malayali Amo. And that's the fun of being a Lopez, Anthony Lopez in India. This is a slide basically which will apply to, I think, almost all of us, but it greatly applies to me. My father basically comes from a village in Karnataka, and very early in his childhood, he ran away from his home because his mother died and his father remarried, so he couldn't take it, so he ran away. And so he ran away as a pauper and landed up in Bombay, later landed up in Ahmedabad. And I think these were strokes of luck which happened to him. From Bombay, somebody recommended to go to Ahmedabad for a job. And so he landed up, and then he took up a little small house out there in one shanty, And that's where he met my mother. My mother was educated, my father was not educated, he was just barely 10th pass. And my mother was yet educated, he was a neighbor, and in true Bollywood style, he fell in love with her and married her against her parents' wishes. Yeah. And that's how basically we came into the picture. So that's the picture in front of our house. We used to live in one room house, and you can see that all the kids are well dressed. My father is having a nice coat because that's he's just been to Germany and come back, right? So my father basically, when he came to Ahmedabad, he applied to NID as a block maker, and he was lucky, he got the job. My mother helped him fill the application, because of which I think he got the job. And there we are. I mean, my father basically got training in Switzerland and Germany on block making, and Yeah, he became very good at his job. Yeah, and but that's where basically the aspect of design got seeded in my life as a young child. I used to go to NID very often. Yeah, and I spent most of my life in this chawl growing up, right? And I used to play Gilli Danda, Bambeda. And when things got better for us in our house, my father got a cycle, and that was the pride of thing for us. You know, and I used to play with his cycle once he came home, turning the wheels and putting a paper inside. And one fine day, I got admission myself into NID. So I think this is a whole stroke of luck which happened to me. Yeah, that's what I look like when I passed out of NID, not too different from what I am now. But I always show this picture to everybody in context to what happened in my life. It's like a lottery. Yeah, I was one among 1.4 million billion people. The point which I'm trying to make is that I'm one among billion people standing in front of you, currently sitting. And India is a huge country of people with unequal opportunities. And it's truly unequal opportunities. India, that is quirky, idiocentric, unpredictable, and for all of us, truly lovable. But I want to make a point in context to this whole journey which we have taken so far, in context to 1.4 billion people, in context to another argument which I'm going to put forward, right? And that's where I'm introducing you to Sam Harris, you know, and he's got this book called Free Will. So he says free will is an illusion, right? And Sam Harris basically combines neuroscience, psychology to basically lay this illusion to rest. And he argues this whole concept that you actually do not have free will. But what I will draw from this is this point which he's making. Yeah, that you cannot take credit for your talents, but it matters that you use them. You cannot really be blamed for your weakness, but it matters that you correct them. So pride and shame do not make a lot of sense. And in the final analysis, they want fun anyway. They want great. So what he's saying is that everything what you have got in context to your talent is something which has come as a stroke of luck to you because of the genes of your parents, etc., etc. If you're born in a wealthy home or a home which could educate you, that's another aspect of luck. So right from your genes to the situation you are in and things, how it unfolds for you as an individual, it's a stroke of luck, right? And thereby, basically, what are you proud of? You know? And thereby, he talks about the aspect of that we need to be, you know, doing something with what we have been gifted with. And if we have weakness, then we got to do something about correcting that weakness or improving from that situation. And I think this is where I seed my thinking and my reasoning for doing what I'm doing, right? In that sense. And so he says basically pride and shame are redundant, effectively. That's what he says. So it's important that there is a commitment to the well-being and improving life. So what is design? Design is about innovation, change, making things better, you know. But what better for what? Improving life, right? And life of others. And thereby, in this whole game of thing, your ego becomes an illusion, truly. I mean, it's a qual, and that's where I bring this whole thing. And to this, basically, what the conclusion of this whole discussion is so far is that we are all differently abled. And if we are designing for the world where every individual is differently abled, then that's a very mega challenge, because the world so far is putting everybody in one big box and then thin slicing them into 1 million people. So many billion people, men, so many billion women, and they all behave in a similar manner and thereby, you know, box them and sell them everything, right? But individually, we are all differently able. And I think that's very important to understand. And I think it's a fact. Now I'm going to again shift a little bit here. I forgot to put in the blink slide here. But this is about our country, India. India is like a khichdi. It's a melting pot of cultures. Where it is difficult to specify where one started and where one ended. For those of us who have never eaten khichdi, and some of us would not have eaten, I would recommend that you try and eat it to understand what India truly is. तो हिंदी में कहते हैं हम खिचड़ी है बट इज रियली रियली टेस्टी राइट एंड आई लव खिचड़ी सो जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्टेक्स्ट दैट वी वर 1000 वॉरिंग स्टेट्स यू नो बिफोर वी बिकेम वन नाउ वी आर 28 I mean, like 30 states, you know, and 7 union territories, speaking 18 official languages, 1.4 billion people, you know, and occupying some 3 million square kilometers of space, right? Huge, huge country, such massive diversity, massive and highly complex diversity, right? Yet we treat this whole India as one, right? It is one, but we are so different from each other. This is a slide I show. In context to that, we same Indians, we believe in luck, big time. Hum subah akhbar padhte hain, when we go to Delhi Times or whatever times we read, and the first thing we'll do is bhavishya dekhte hain. So we rely so much on our luck and somebody predicting our luck. The other thing very critical about India and massively critical about India that 98% of us believe in God, right? Maybe that figure is reducing a little bit every year. Our reverence is so high, and we build our homes, streets, plan major projects around them. And God tells us from right and wrong. But how does He tell us? He tells us through His representatives, right? The pandit tells us, "Ke bhai, is disha ghar banao, aise banao, type of thing. Is din pe banao." I show these slides in conjunction because the guy on the right is super famous. But the guy on the left is also Mukesh, but he's Mukesh, a cook. Mukesh has been cooking in my house for many, many years. And one day Mukesh gives me this leaflet, "Hey, bhaiya, aap apne doston se baanto, taki, you know, I can make some extra money." You know, so India is a land of entrepreneurs. Some Ambanis, Tatas, Reddys, Mittals, and the millions who are entrepreneurs out of sheer necessity. Mukesh, my cook, wants to do work more harder, wants to get more work. Because he wants to feed his family, he wants to get his two daughters married, you know, collect enough money so he can give them a good marriage. You know? But what is important that right, both the Mukeshes believe that we can do anything. Hum kuch bhi kar sakte hain, hum karne taiyar hain, theek hai? And entrepreneurs are willing to take risk. In this case, both of them took great risk. We are confident and raring to go. All we need to do is convince other people that we are doing the right thing for their business. This is another important slide. I will let you soak into what it says. And you should see the grin on this little boy, young boy's face. We say the world is looking at us and is interested in us and is greatly interested in everybody, right? We need to present ourselves confidently and we are just as good as anybody else. We only need to look at it in context to our own world. So, ab waqt hamara hai. We are ready for the world. Is the world ready for us? In the Global Attitude Survey, there was a survey conducted sometime back. 93% of Indians believe that our culture is far superior. And quoting Farid Zakaria in reference to India. So Farid Zakaria is a very famous columnist. And he says, as if hundreds of billions of people have suddenly discovered keys to unlock their potential. We should not forget who we are and where we are from. This does not mean our work has to typically look Indian. But it's very important that we should be grounded in India. And that's a very good beginning. So what I'm going to do now is to very quickly show you a couple of examples of how, and you are the judge for that in context to how does this thinking or this way of doing things and applying oneself actually comes into work. And it is not about how does it benefit me, it's about how it benefits my clients and my clients' clients. Who's my client's client? My clients and clients are the customers. So their customers are my clients. That's how I see things. So Nestway, basically, I don't know how many of you know Nestway, but Nestway is into the business of providing rentals or properties for young people who migrate from one place to the other for jobs. And typically they give them a fully furnished house, you know, so that the guy or the young person, you know, migrating does not have to worry about all these chairs, table, button, all these things, right? And this is what Nestway looked like when they came to us. And if you can see that there is housing there, there is Coho there, there are various organizations also there on this page. And typically everybody does the same thing. They promises you a happy life, fun life, and everybody is smiling and happy there. And thereby there is no actual difference between one service and the other in context to competition. And this is just to show you the job, that how complex our job becomes in terms of understanding businesses and so research study becomes very critical and important. Anybody who's a designer knows this, but typically we get quite extensive to understand the entire business to the granular level, right? So this is a nutshell in terms of what Nestway is about. And so we at Nestway excel in providing basic amenities for young urban migrants. And I'll tell you where we made the difference. So this definition already existed in context to Nestway. We said that because we bring young people together to live in homes, either individually or in groups, you know, where one person is living in one room and the apartment is shared by 3-4 people, or there are people sharing one room also, there are 2 beds in one room, and so we're bringing many people together, right? So what happens is basically automatically because of that, that a platform is created, that these people now who never met before are intermingling and they are doing things together, right? But what is important, what we want these young people to feel is, we want the young people when they're migrating from their comfortable homes to feel comfortable, that they have, that they are welcome and they belong to a community. And these platform acts as catalyst enabling young migrants to explore and create their own world. And we say catalyst because we do not want to dictate what these young people do. We just want to give them an opportunity, a platform. So this is the presentation. This is the exact presentation we did to the client when they're presenting their identity. So we designed a new identity system for Nestway based on this particular entire approach of platform creation, right? So we said, what are we giving people? We give them a house. A house is what? It's the box, right? But our house is not a normal house which we give people. We give them a house which we can have friends. We can do cooking there, music and flex. Yeah, you can have celebrations. You can make new friends. Smart connections. Tribes. We all know the world is extremely thin-sliced in context of tribes. Active community. And late impact the world. Chappad bhaar sakte hum. That's what young people are about. So an identity basically is, so this is what the whole identity became. This exactly became the whole identity in our show. There's a longer video of the same thing on our website. But it showcases basically how the identity works and how the language works. So what we did was we created a unique language for the brand. Yeah. This is the flexibility of a simple box, and it becomes a voice box where you can put something inside the box or outside the box or both. And when you do that, you have contextual referencing happening. And these are a few examples. So out of the blue, what we did was we created this entire system. It became an extremely unique system in the competitive landscape. Nobody had this way of talking, right? Or the way of expression. And it was the language of the youth. It is currently. And everything was said in a certain style, in a certain method. We also developed, so here what we did for Nestway is full service design. That means consumer experience design, CX, right from the identity, the language, the entire social media templates, everything, right to their website, the app, everything. So we redesigned everything from scratch in context to how would somebody approach Nestway, how would Nestway talk to them, how would they deliver the entire experience. Everything was changed and designed from ground up, you know. And one of the things what happened is because it started looking very different from anybody else. Besides that also, it became extremely fast in terms of delivery. So because everything was vector graphics, right? And vector is extremely light. And that allowed them to download extremely fast on any app, even with low connectivity. So you can see the t-shirts out there. The one in the center there, the red t-shirt, is my favorite. There's a little heart inside and says room for more. There is a toilet out there. So this toilet, there's a small sticker. So the client was saying initially, okay, we should put some posters in all the homes with the rules of do and don'ts. And so I said, no, there should be no do and don'ts posters, you know. So, but we should have Nestway somewhere. So we put in the boys' apartments, we put this sticker on the top. It says, I hope you can read that. This is a brand book which we create for all the employees, you know. So we did the ABCD of the value system or the manifesto. So it says A for affordable, B for belonging, sense of belonging. And incidentally, since HP is here, I should really appreciate their Indigo machine, because for the launch, we actually had to print something overnight. So these are small booklets. They are A6 size booklets. And so we had to print about 50 of them and send it across to Bangalore from here, Delhi. And overnight, we could do this job. And thanks to the Indigo machine, which managed this very well. But at the end of this book, it's about 30-40 page book, right? It talks about various aspects of Nestway. And it's for the employees, remember. So it says, you know, the promise I have to make. And it says, make everybody feel at home. Yes, everyone. Feel what the customer feel always. Set the right expectations every time. So on and so forth. And then in last, it says, smile always, as it can always move mountains. And then you're supposed to sign there on the booklet. Project. So the other project which we did, so you see the diversity of projects because we work across a very wide range of clients. And so we got an opportunity, we got selected among many design firms across the world to do the branding for Bihar Museum. And this is one of its kind museum which is there in Patna. And we were brought in to do the entire branding, wayfinding, signage, website. Again, full service design for Bihar Museum. So we all know that Bihar Museum, Bihar was a great place once upon a time, right? 2000 years ago, it seeded a lot of great things, you know, right from religion, empires, great minds, etc. And thereby we can safely say that it was a place where the body, the mind and soul was taken care of, right? Where great governance happened, supreme knowledge happened, you know, through the universities, education, and of course through Buddhism and Jainism and all those religions, the way of life was well sorted out. So it was a perfect dwelling place, right? And thereby we came up with the strategy of that can the museum become the gateway to the past and the portal to the future? And thereby can it become the ultimate dwelling place, you know, the ultimate abode, Param Vihara? And he said, if this is the Param Vihara, this is the ultimate place, what should be the personality of this museum? Because museum, even their buildings, even their brands, everything has a personality, you know. And thereby, because this, the whole expression of the museum was so grand and great, it is Amitabh Bachchan of Amitabh Bachchan, right? And then we said, how should the museum behave? So I'll just read out this thing from the booklet, which I have again an A6 size page. Again, printed on Indigo, the first lot, you know, and then later in Pragati. Yeah. Sorry, I've got the Hindi version here. So I won't read, I'll leave it to you. But again, this is a behavior book. And we said that, you know, in order to change the behavior of people who serve your customers, you just have to read this book and automatically you'll start behaving with your customers in a certain manner. So we created this entire prose. So what we told the client that actually a physical entity and a physical space is just a small experience. So what you see in the center is the band, right? And the band is actually the physical museum experience which you got. And the other experience lies in the virtual world, right? In the world, in the minds of people. So it's like Taj Mahal. The entire world wants to come to Taj Mahal, but a very few people land up at Taj Mahal. But that the knowledge, the story of Taj Mahal is far and wide across the world. And likewise, basically every museum, every entity, every institution needs to do the same. And the effort which you need to put in to get the world to know you is enormous. So you got to tell fantastic stories. Yeah. And this is the identity which we created for them. This identity is again well known because we challenge the norms. It is something which we as designers have always been taught that identity has to be an Apple or a state bank and something. But we struggled a lot in context to, but how can you have a single entity for 2,000 years of history in that sense, right? So because Bihar Museum is, Bihar is many, many things. And Bihar Museum has many, many things, many stories. So here is a story. I say Bihar Museum is not in a hurry to tell you its story, right? So it has got the triad of trees out there. It has got the Bodhi tree there. It's got this Bihar on English and Hindi version, one on top of the other. There's the lines going across the Suri Rekha. And each one of them has got a meaning and a story. And we will tell you these stories in time. What you see there is the inauguration pictures and the signage system in place. This is the entire collateral. So again, what we did was we used the Hindi script very, very strongly and powerfully. And we said, no matter where we are showcasing Bihar Museum, in posters across the world, digital media, we'll always have the Hindi script there, you know, as part of things. Because it's very important that people understand that you have to see India through its own lens. And language and culture and its history is its lens. You cannot take look at an object and say, oh, how beautiful it is. But you got to understand it far more deeper. You know, so the word Pratima is there. We all know Pratima has got many meanings. And thereby in English, there could have all the meanings there in place. There's a little bag, the toe bag which you take away after you buy something. It says Anmol. We also did the wayfinding and signage system along with our partners. And so this is the wayfinding strategy in context to how the movement will happen within the museum. So along with the architects, we do all these things. And then we decide where each sign system has to come, what type of sign has to come. This is the signage system. And what you can see here is a totem pole on your left. So that is an extremely thin pole, right? Totem. And we had a challenge of how to design it and finally how to make it. And the biggest fear was that there are going to be thousands of people coming into the museum. That is so from Patna, from all over the place, from villages. And how will this survive the onslaught of that number of people, you know, touching it and doing things. Yet we managed to design it well and currently it still holds good, right? And people don't normally touch it. Because I think when you design something well, people learn how to respect it on their own. You don't have to tell them. Good example is Delhi Metro, right? I think it's spick and span. People respect it and you don't see so much of abuse happening there. This is another interesting project and I'll move a little bit quickly because I think we'll run out of time very soon. Ayushman Bharat. So we were brought in to design the branding for Ayushman Bharat, and Ayushman Bharat is about, so we have about 150,000 health centers across the world across the country, sorry. And we were brought in to design the so-called fascia of these health centers. And the exercise was supposed to be done very urgently. And so we said that what can we do so that people can own these health centers, that they feel that this is for them and it is them, you know, and they should, because one of the biggest issues with people in villages is that they all already practicing local medicines, and when they have problems, then they hesitate to go to the health center. So we wanted them to come closer and feel better, feel more comfortable with health centers. So we came up with this idea, very simple idea of, you know, painting the walls and then asking them to create two parallel lines around an illustration, right? Very simple. And because no two health centers look the same, they're all different architectures, different buildings, small, big, different types of things happening there. So we say you can take a door or a window and you just draw these two parallel lines, certain size of illustration, and you apply it, right? And so one local artist would, or a painter would apply it in this fashion, another one would do it differently. And we said that in this particular two parallel lines, you can put your local patterns, right? So this is an example of how. So Varli would come in Maharashtra, Gondar would come in Madhya Pradesh. So we left it to the people in villages, in towns, you know, to do their own artwork within a certain template system. So we gave them, a brand book, you know, how to do it in different languages, and send it out. And they send it out through WhatsApp. So this is a WhatsApp creation. And what we started seeing is these wonderful pictures, because they would send us WhatsApp pictures at the end of the day. And Lope Design has got nothing to do with the final creation. It is all Raju and Mahesh and, you know, so and so artists, local artists doing these things. And what you see on the center top is something from Mizoram. Right. So, and there you can see that they've even changed the illustrations a little bit to look like Mizoramis, right? And what you see on the left is basically Andamans. So recently a colleague of mine went to the Andamans, and then they saw these turtles and these beautiful things, what they did on the walls, right? And none of us told them what to do. They just did it. And that's what's great about this design. And they own it, and they know, okay, you know, so and so person has done it from my village. This is another project which we got for a very large conference. So there's a big conference happening in Delhi, global conference on women, children and adolescents. And we were brought into the branding for that conference. So what we did differently for this particular conference was we did the entire logo on cloth. Ek kapde se banaya logo hai pura. And we brought in Pipli craft people from Pipli, and these women, you know, we went to the village, in fact, and then sat with them and they created this patchwork, right? And the entire logo is made of applique work. And the actually logo has got a lot of story in it, in context to what is the conference aim and etc., you know. And we made sure that those six things were part of the story, and the logo came in place. And it immediately got accepted right at the prime minister level and at the global level, right at WHO level. Everybody started connecting with it greatly, because using fabric, first of all, we connected to fabric of life. And at the end of the day, it's handmade by people, right? Nothing better than that. So it's a big super hit. And we launched this logo 1 year before the conference so that they could do advocacy work and build the whole drum up to the conference. Yeah, this is the end picture. The team which was responsible, global team which was responsible, they're very proud of what happened. So you can see Narendra Modi and Priyanka Chopra launching the identity. You can see, the bags which we made similarly with patchwork and all. And the bags don't have the logo. The logo is actually in a badge which is there. So you can use the bag for ordinary work, everyday work, right? And on the left, again, the bottom, what you see is the conference banners and all this. So again, all backdrop, there was no flex used at all, you know. And everything what happened was done on cloth, and it was hung, you know. And one more very important thing, that everything what was done for the conference was reusable, you know. So what you see behind there in the conference hall is this banners there vertical on the left bottom. Each one of them is actually can be separated and made into pillow covers. Yeah, and you can see the pillow cover on the, there's a girl holding the pillow cover on the extreme right. So what I did was, after the conference got over, it's a two-day conference, there was a board meeting happened. I went and met with the board members. And I said, they were actually very, very happy with the entire project. But I said, this is not what I'm here for. I'm here for a different purpose. And I showed them these slides, these two slides and many more slides. And I said that here these designs have been accepted and loved by everybody who has seen it. Why can't we give away these designs to the people, crafts people, and let them produce it commercially, right? And they immediately said yes. And I've been working with these people for now almost 3 years, you know, trying to get these designs into commerce. And as we speak currently, there's a very big foundation, a bank foundation, which has gone to Pipli and is talking to them and seeing how they can make it work for them end to end. Produce the whole thing and market it to the world in that sense. And hopefully if that works out, then this is a very good example of how we conceived an identity for a conference, which is only meant for 2 days. We made bags and all those things there, and a lot of people took all these things home. They're still using those things, right? So the conference memory stays alive. Everything has been repurposed. And eventually what we did was, you know, it created economic growth for the craft people. And that's what the process is going on. And thereby we have a multi-pronged sustainable development impact. So this is how we conceived the entire thing. Did I think about it right in the beginning? The answer is no. But I think because of the way I think and the way my team thinks, you know, that these ideas seep in everything what we do. This is very quickly the recent projects which we have done. Ace23 is a gaming company. We repositioned them into being a company not where everybody was advertising about how much money you can earn and how you can become rich from gaming. We said, can we shift focus to being responsible gaming and championship and things like that? We're learning the craft of gaming, becoming a champion, a great cricketer, you know, things like that. And money is all a byproduct of everything, right? And this is a new identity which we created. So what happened was, if you see that Ace23 was written in this manner, we brought it down to just purely A23, which I said people will say Ace23. They bought the A23.com, and we created a new identity for them with a new positioning altogether. They got it in Shah Rukh Khan, and you must be seeing these ads. Play responsibly. This is also a latest project we did for a company in New York. It's a digital education platform which creates with programs for clients. So it's a B2B brand. And like there are so many people who produces technology for learning, right? And we said, how can we differentiate them? And we said that we can differentiate them by saying that we can do better than anybody else in context to being inclusive as a brand. That we can actually create tools for anybody and everybody to learn from, you know? So, and today the inclusivity is a big subject, and thereby we brought in the whole positioning of digital learning for everyone. The brand is called Magic Ed Tech. And you can see how it works across different communication. So the whole aspect of humanism and touch and feel, and then learning through that mode. The latest project has just been launched just a few work weeks back, and Academy. So we created a conversational brand, which talks to you and which aspires you in the bargain, right? And so this is and Academy is an upskilling platform which allows you to come and learn and upskill yourself, right? So you already, finished your studies, and now you want to upskill yourself, or you're doing a job and you want to upskill in the field of design, UI, UX, and all those fields. And this is what And Academy is just about. It's launched recently. So this is the last slide, or the second last slide, which actually makes a bold and a strong statement about our stance.
Thank you so much, Mr. Anthony.
So one last word. So just wanted to show you that, you know, it doesn't happen. I'm the person presenting you all this work, but there's a huge team behind it. And I think everybody is important in that contribution of what has taken Lopez Design this far. Yeah. And I'm going to hand over, I think, to Ashok, who's going to take on to the next presentation, which is, I think, equally exciting, where he talks about how they have produced, I think, a magazine which has got many, many different avatars, and also where he talks about how the physical and the virtual world merges together. You know, so I think that's another exciting presentation. Over to you, Sanya and Ashok, and thank you so much. I think please keep your questions active because there should be a lot of questions after what I presented. So looking forward to them. Over to you, Ashok, and thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Anthony. That was really a unique presentation. All those blinks really opened our eyes to a lot many interesting things, ideas, and concepts. So our next speaker for the evening is Mr. Ashok Pawa. He's a business manager at Indigo, specifically at HP Indigo, specifically focused on India and Sri Lanka. His career in printing technology spans nearly two decades, where he has been associated with companies like Technova, Xerox, and now HP. Owing to his industry experience, he has a deep understanding of designers' pain points and needs with respect to print and the innovative possibilities of print technology. I'm now going to give the floor to Mr. Ashok Pawa.
Sure. Thank you so much, Sanya. And Mr. Anthony, it was really, really wonderful. I could see a lot many hearts coming out to you. This is the way of expressions, you know, in the today's world from the younger generation. A lot many claps and lot many, you know, appreciation which was coming out for all the work that you have done. Seriously, you know, I could have been in touch with you before making my presentation, because my presentation is not as powerful, you know, as you just really finished the work that you have done. But I'll try to make it, you know, a little more interactive and interesting. Let me just share my screen with you. And just let me know if you able to see my screen. If somebody can confirm me up, that would be a help.
Yes, your screen is visible.
Okay, all right, Sanya. So, good evening and welcome. This is an initiative of Creative Gaga along with an HP Indigo to have an interaction with the design community from, you know, from both the brand perspective as well as from the service, you know, technology service provider from an HP Indigo. We actually started this journey of collaboration, you know, many, many years before when we started our operations in India in 2007, where we tried reaching out to all the brands, agencies. But the active participation with all of you actually started just before the COVID, when the time was, you know, time was not right for all of us. And this was a time where we wanted to utilize our time in upskilling and understanding and more collaboration to happen. And that's where we came into picture. And we started this journey of, you know, the talk tracks or the webinars or the interaction with the mentors like Mr. Anthony Lopez and many other previous mentors that we have to come and speak about their experience to the new generation, the talented creative people who are sitting into this forum, who can learn from 20 years, 25, 30 years of an experience in 40 minutes and really absorb it and use it to their benefit. So that was the whole purpose of me collaborating and creating this platform for the young designers and community. Continuing what Mr. Lopez has just, you know, I'll summarize three things from Mr. Lopez. One is India is 1.4 billion of a population which is treated as a one consumer. Right? This is what which has been happening in, you know, design in the brand industry for almost like 3 decades since our liberalization of, you know, in 1991, and you know we are at 2022, which is changing, you know, in a big time now. Second is, as a creative people, being such a dynamic, living in a such dynamic world, interacting with different platforms, I think this is the time, if you are, you know, 2 decades into the business, this is the philosophy of, you know, learning. Earlier the philosophy was learn and use your experience to create, you know, or replicate your learning. But I think the time now is actually learn, unlearn and relearn. All right, this is how I would love to put it. And third thing is, of course, use the technology to your benefit to create a right experience for your customers and customers' customers, which is your brand and the end consumer. And this is where, you know, HP comes into picture, HP Indigo comes into picture, and we collaborate with all the designers and young designers like you. So this is what I think, you know, last 2 decades, the world is completely, completely changed for all of us. The way we used to navigate, the way we used to see television, the way we used to, you know, hear to the music, the way we use taxis, anything and everything. You know, if somebody is of my age, which is, you know, 40s and 50s, they have seen this huge change coming from 2000 onwards, and, you know, the life is changing completely. But what this has done to us is completely change the way the market is using these services, which means the consumers who are using these services, and the consumers have completely changed for us. This is creating a bigger change for the brand and the creative agencies. And let's understand who are the consumers now. You know, the consumers are actually sitting in this forum. You know, these are the millennials and Gen Zs. These are the, you know, generation of YOLO, FOMO and MOZO. You know, you use it very often. You know, you only live once. Fear of missing out and the joy of missing out. These are the terminologies that is being used by this generation. And the basic necessity of this generation is also very different. You know, the battery and Wi-Fi has become, you know, the basic need in the whole of the, you know, the need theory that we have, which means the world today is the world of attention economy. All right, what do I mean by an attention economy? Is an economy of an attention. Today, as a, you know, as a consumer, we spend close to around 3 hours 40 minutes on a mobile. And we are bombarded by the content which is generated by, you know, family, friends, brands, marketers, advertisers, and who not. And every content which is generated is competing for our attention, right? And whosoever wins that attention is actually a winner in this whole game. Now, if I look at the content which is getting generated today, this is the amount of the content which is getting generated today. Huge amount of a content, you know. If you see the numbers of posts, 2.5 million posts, 3.8 million search, and 600,000, 900,000, these are the kind of a content which is getting generated, you know, in 1 minute of an internet world. Now, as a consumer, if I see myself as a consumer, or, you know, you're working for a brand is working for a consumer, and I'm a consumer today, this much of a content is bombarded onto me every minute. Now, when we have those much of a content, what it creates, it creates a lot of distraction. And when we have a lot of noise, we have a lot of distraction, which means our attention span has declined over the last 2 decades. This is what has really happened to us as a consumer. You know, my attention span was 12 seconds in year 2000, which has come to, you know, 8 seconds, comparing it to, you know, the goldfish, which has got an attention span of 9 seconds. Now, if this is the attention span, this is the time that I can maximum spend, you know, as a complete focus onto one particular message, or you know, the targeted message that I'm getting it. Look at the life of, you know, the marketers or companies like you, or a brands like you, or a creative agencies like you, and of course the family and the speakers like us. We have to really work much more harder than before to earn your attention. And we have to really work hard. We have to stand out to be heard. And this is what is really happening, you know, when we see the whole of the cycle, the life cycle of any product and services. When we look into any product life cycle today, we see that the product life cycle is getting shortened and shortened and shortened every day. Today, you know, every day there are thousands and thousands of, you know, the products and services are getting launched. You know, Mr. Lopez has took taken a lot of examples of the Dinesh Dave, who was one of the entrant into one of the physical space, coming on a virtual world and trying to engage with the consumers. Likewise, there are so much of the variations which is happening in the market because of the generations who is demanding it. And now, if this is the state of my business, if I'm a brand today and this is the state of my business, I have to change. I have to become more agile. I have to become more quality conscious as a brand. I have to become more creative. Of course, I have to become more eco-friendly and, the food safe and the brand protection. And on my behalf, actually, you as a design agency or a creative agency, you create a bridge between brand and the consumer. And that's where you come into the chain of communication and create that engagement platform or a communication platform in this whole dynamic world of consumer who is changing brands. And through you, we are reaching out to the consumers back again and trying to pull them to buy my products and services. This is what is really happening. Now, when the world has become so competitive and the world has become, super attentions and full of distractions, of course, the life of a brand is very different. The life of a brand is very challenging. And today, this is what a brand look forward to you. I know when you speak to the brand, they come with the problem statements. And when you really group those problem statements, you will find, one of the statements coming to you for a particular problem. I want to engage more with my customers. I want more, ROI onto my marketing investment. I want to cut down my cost. I want to optimize my supply chain. I want to connect the digital world or a digital campaign with the real product, with the real world. I want to reduce my time to market. I want to reach out to the market as early as possible. And of course, I have to be seen as an eco-friendly or a sustainable company. Now, sometimes brand comes with one problem statement which falls into, one of the bigger group category. Or sometimes they really come forward and say, I need two of these, I need three of these. But trust me, these are the values that a brand is looking forward from you as a creative agency or a brand strategist to offer it to them, through your creativity and specialization. And that's where we will come into picture. And, we will definitely talk about this, where HP Indigo will come and collaborate with you and, help each other to get these kind of an objectives into the place. But let me take the biggest three out of the whole, the values that the brand is looking forward from. The first and the foremost is, of course, engage with the customers. This is not new. This is happening for many, many years. The brand values, the brand connect, the communication is all through the agencies, all through the creativity, all through the different communication media, which is electronic media or a print media or the cloth platform that a brand is using to influence the customers to, to pull them into their own philosophy. And let us see, let us take one particular case study. Let me put this video first. This is a brand which came to India in the late 90s and wanted to really enter into the larger gamut of, the Indian industry from metro to rural. And this is what they did in early 2000, which is 2002 and 2003. Sorry, I hear the sound.
Chale thanda de. Second day kya raha hai? अबे तो आदमी है क्या अंडा तेरे से ठंडा मांगा ना ठंडा ये बिना टेरेस की बिल्डिंग फोड़ू कैन बम हाँ तेरे से ठंडा मांगा ना क्या ला रहा है भाई
लेकिन ठंडा ही तो है
अबे फ्लावर पॉट ठंडा मतलब कोका कोला समझा ठंडा मतलब
कोका कोला
हाँ अब बोल ठंडा मतलब
कोका कोला
ठंडा मतलब कोका कोला
I think the audience which is sitting here must remember this ad or should remember this ad. Tanda matlab Coca-Cola. This was a punchline. This was a tagline which Coke at a particular timeline when they wanted to expand their market from metros to semi-metros to semi-rurals and the rural market where they were not competing with any other brand. But they were competing with, the traditional coolant which was used in our community. It was not cool drink. It was always, lassi. It was always nimbu pani. It was always other coolant which were competing with this brand. And that's where they really, hook onto one statement You know, in an Indian culture, when somebody, some guest comes to us, what we ask them is, thanda loge ya garam? You know, which means you will take, you know, the coolant, or you will take something hot, which is tea most of the time. And some of the creative like you has picked up this natural behavior, very common behavior, and put this subject, you know, coke as a thanda. And that's where the expanded, you know, widely into the rural market of India and become the one of the most prominent brand. This was a time of 2002-2003. And then, of course, you know, once you get into a market share, that, you know, the whole of the dynamics is very different, that, you know, the things are changing very fast. At some point of a time, the same brand who had a one philosophy, one problem statement, now came with a second problem statement. And that's what really happened. Now, let me show you the second part of the story, which is not in India, little outside India, 10 years after, you know, 2002. And then we will talk about 2019 as well.
Last September, in the dead of night, the world's most iconic brand did the unthinkable and took an entire country by surprise. 150 of Australia's most popular names appeared on millions of bottles of Coke. Why? Because in the previous month alone, 50% of teens and young adults hadn't even tasted a Coke. We had to reconnect with Australia, so we decided to get personal. The internet blew up straight away, but we kept quiet. And while the buzz grew and grew, we recruited our fans and made them the face of our campaign. Then, on Australia's highest rated media weekend, we came clean and invited Australians all over to share a Coke.
Kate and Kate, the two Kates. Classy Kate. Crazy Kate. If you know a Kate, share a Coke with Kate, or Mel, or Dave, or Jay.
Our message was everywhere. Digitally and interactively at Sydney's iconic Coke billboard. Whichever way you turned, it was you and your friends up in lights. The media instantly took notice. Blogs lit up. Australia had fallen in love.
Coca-Cola.
Sharing a Coke.
Thousands of requests poured in for more names, but we were ready. With kiosks where you could get any name printed on a Coke can, people couldn't get enough, queuing for hours. But the requests kept flooding in. So we put it to a vote and asked Australia who they wanted to share a Coke with most. And after 65,000 people got their say, 50 new names were released. We invited everyone to share a Coke, and share they did. Whether old or young, drinkers or non-drinkers, friends searched for names, tagged one another, shared stories. Australians everywhere were once more connecting over the world's most iconic brand. And with the holidays looming, we celebrated and shared a Coke with a friend who brings a smile to every face. In just 3 short months, 5% more people were drinking Coke. Sales transactions grew by 3%. Volume increased by 4%. An 870% increase in Facebook traffic. 12,020,000 earned media impressions. 76,000 virtual Coke cans shared. 378,000 extra Coke cans printed at kiosks. And one country painted red. With one simple tweak to a label, Coke once again became part of popular culture.
So what really happened is, you know, from 2002 to 2014, you know, the problem statement remained the same. They wanted to reach out to the audience, but this time it was not the mass audience. It was not the mass communication of a rural, but it was a very targeted audience of, you know, the teenagers and the teens who never tasted Coke. And this whole campaign was actually designed and targeted for that. And the interesting part of this is the campaign started with the print and went to electronic media. So it's a good amalgamation of, you know, the physical world with the digital world. And, you know, we call it as a digital world, where the whole of the interaction was placed in a physical form on a bottle. And then it went on to the media. And this is what really happened. Just, you know, the day after, if you see the retail stores, which were flooded like this, and lot many electronic content which is generated, you know, this is the result, you know. I'm really not going deep into it, but of course this is what really happened after 10 years. And as I said, you know, this was not only Australia, the same problem, you know, happened in India. And because, you know, we are 1.4 billion population with all different names in small size of a one letter to a five letters, we really could not fit, you know, one personalized name onto a bottle. So what we really did is we went back again, you know, with the creative people and branding, you know, agencies like of Mr. Lopez. And we really checked what is the biggest value an Indian really do want to express. And that's where it came into picture, was a relationship. We all value relationship, you know, and that relationship was more important for an Indian than a personalization. And that's where we came in India in 2018-19 of this campaign.
मुझे करना पड़ता है सब कुछ. अभी किचन अनपैक कर रही हूँ, उसके बाद लिविंग रूम एंड देन डाइनिंग रूम. आई मीन सांस लेने का भी टाइम नहीं है.
वो भी ऐसे ही बैठे बैठे मेरे काम का क्रेडिट खा जाता है. Please continue, baby.
Har rishta bola, mere naam ki Coca Cola.
Yeah. So this is what happened in India, and you know this campaign was very very well appreciated. And you know why I'm expressing this campaign to you today is because this was a true collaboration of our brand problem, our creative agencies like all of you, and HP Indigo as a technology provider. So what we did is the biggest relationships which was expressed by creative people, right? There were 238 total relationship which was created as a tagline, you know, from Bai to Baba to BFF and, you know, what and what not. And we printed those relationships into 12 different languages. And as a technology, we printed 900 to 9,200 unique designs on a Coke bottle. So this is a true collaboration between creativity and the technology to come out with a real solution from the brand. And this is where the collaboration will come into picture. So that's the first thing first. As I said, you know, there are three values. One is engage with the customer. And of course, in the digital world, this is what we need to do, you know, expressing the physical as well as the virtual need of the environment. Second is, you know, today every brand wants to really come out and express it to the audience, to the consumer, that, you know, this is not about me, me and me. This is about you, you and you as a consumer. And many, many of the brands are really getting into repositioning, you know, their own brand strategies, and they are changing the way they want it to perceive. And that's where we think as the next step, a designer can really come into picture, a creative can really come into picture and express, not even express, I would say, help us to really change the brand value from a brand to a value for a consumer. And just in the interest of the time, I will not really play this video, but what really this done is, if you see the statement which was made by Kleenex, it says, always by your side when the care is needed. And what they did is, they associated with, the senior citizen school program in Korea. And after the graduations of, you know, the grandmothers, you know, these are the grandmothers about 67, 70, 80s. After their graduation, they wrote one poem in Korean and they printed the whole of the poem into the Kleenex box. And the whole of the journey of, you know, from a literate, illiterate to literate is expressed in the form of a poem. And it was truly, truly expressed in the tissue box or a tissue, the packaging. And again, the value which is created was always by your side when the care is needed. So this is again where, you know, I said the creativity and technology comes into picture. Not only in Korea, you know, we have seen this, it became a big news in India. You know, this was one of the news which really came one single day. If you see this news, I never saw, you know, this kind of a big news in any of the media where it says, Dettol is actually going away from their logo to put COVID warriors on their bottle, on their label. And this was a news on January 8, 2021, in one of the Hindi newspaper called Z News Hindi. And this was a salute campaign, which was from Dettol, where Dettol really did this. They put 100 top warriors as a stories. They put their picture, their stories, and they really removed the Dettol logo from their you know, from their front face of their label and presented this as a salute to the COVID warriors, which means you are more important than my brand onto my bottle itself. And this is the big change, you know, the all of the brands are looking forward to. They want to express their values in the form of or in the language of, you know, we are there for you, you are my consumer and I care for you. So this is the second element for a creative people. I definitely look forward to see as a bigger value that you can actually give it to the brand. And the third and the, you know, the foremost is of course the sustainability. You know, the sustainability is not a buzzword today. You know, we have gone through the surveys and the data clearly says today the millennials and the Gen Z, they want to have 89%. They would rather buy from the companies who support the social and the environmental issues. 89% of the consumers say they will buy from those companies than the company that doesn't. Which means consumer today is very aware. Just before the show, we were talking with Mr. Lopez and you know, some of the young aspiring creative people. And this was a statement which was made by them. And this is where, you know, we as a digital company, we as a digital print company with no MOQs and, you know, all the values which is attached with it, we are proud to present ourselves as one of the most environmental, you know, conscious company in the world today, right? And the way we say this is very simple. What our philosophy, you know, is very simple. Print what you need, where you need and when you need. And when I make this statement, is the print what you need, which means no MOQ. Where you need is a distributed, and when you need is a time to market, right? And when we start doing this, what we really take care of, we really take care of, you know, unnecessarily printing. I don't really want to get into it because this is a sensitive subject, but we definitely want to go away from pulping of a larger volume, which is unsold into the market in any form of a print. Of course, when we don't, when we use digital, we don't use any kind of, you know, conventional plates and cylinders and you know, all other chemicals, and we increase the efficiency of our resources. And last, when we print at a location, right, I don't use transportation at all. And the moment I go away from a transportation, I save a lot of other resources, and my carbon footprint and non-renewable, you know, energy consumption is also, you know, the shipping consumes a lot of energy. And by doing that, you know, the energy consumption is going low. So for us, it's very simple. The day you start sprinting with digital, of course, you are taking care of an environment. And this is, you know, this is a statement that we want to make on a, you know, on a one of the most important day, which is the World Environment Day, which is tomorrow, which I'll talk about it. But in the last, I would love to tell you who we are. And what do we do, and why is, you know, we are saying what we are saying in terms of any field of communication that you are in today, whether you are in a commercial print, whether you are in a book publishing, whether you are into, you know, packaging, labels, flexibles, anywhere, you know, your services are catered to, we can become a part and collaborate with you for the bigger cause. And this is why we say YHP Indigo.
As you turn the page of today and find yourself in that moment of anticipation of what awaits you on the other side of tomorrow, what will help you grow, stay ahead, and make a brilliant impact on the landscape of print? One thing is certain. The pages of tomorrow will be printed by HP Indigo Technology. It all starts with 2 microns of unlimited potential. These encapsulated pigment particles form HP Indigo Electro Inks. Their unique structure makes them pigment agnostic, enabling you to print with the largest variety of colors, inks, and Pantones digital printing has ever seen. When you press print, a laser array composes your image as an invisible electrostatic field on the photo imaging plate. This operation provides a roadmap for the electrified inks and has been scientifically engineered for razor-sharp accuracy, allowing each particle to be attracted to where it belongs and away from where it doesn't. the precisely placed electro ink is then transferred in direct contact onto a heated blanket, which melts the pigment-carrying particles into a smooth film. With every color separation, this thermal offset process is repeated, laying down a perfect tapestry of electro ink until your image is fully developed. The blanket then applies the single layer of film to your media in one piece, already dry and custom tailored to match every contour on the surface of your substrate, from coated paper to metallized to canvas. Because the electro inks have been transferred in direct contact at every step, the result is unmatched, and neither coverage nor substrate have any effect on quality, even at the highest speeds. HP PrintOS is enabling thousands of customers to grow their businesses through a cloud-based platform that simplifies and automates production. And you can put your mind at ease knowing that all HP Indigo presses are engineered with the environment in mind to reduce waste, provide safe inks, and minimize your energy consumption. HP Indigo technology carries you into the next chapter of digital printing, one that isn't bound by gamut, coverage, substrate, or speed. One that gives you the agility to deliver the shortest runs at the highest quality, from business cards and direct mail, to photo books and publishing, to folding cartons and flexible packaging. In white and fluorescent, on black and metallic, on the shelves and in our homes, the profit of tomorrow will be printed by HP Indigo Technology.
And this is what we do in the form of print on different medias with different colors. Your brand name, any color, we can help you with all those colors, including the white, including silver, orange, violet, green, fade resistance, many other color. And as I said, we not only work on to the print part of it, the biggest power that we have is to engage with brand owners in the agency. And we have a dedicated team inside HP, which is actually working with many brands across the globe and really working out with them in terms of a problem statement and what are the solutions that we can work together with all our association, whether it is customers, whether it is design agencies, whether it is creative agencies. And of course, as I said, we always want to collaborate with all of you. If you have any idea, if you have any problem statement, you may not want to come directly with us. What we have created is we have created one virtual platform, which is a designcircle.in, where we have put all the contents that we have done with the brands, all the case studies, all the stories, all the problem statements that we have worked with them in the recent past, not only in India, but across the globe. And we have actually put a section there where you can say, if you want to contribute. And we definitely know that you want to contribute and you want to share your excitement. Just put a note to us and trust me, this business development and a market development team will reach out to you to work with you for your brands and give them a right experience. And in the last, of course, we wish you a World Environment Day, the Earth Day, which is on tomorrow, which is 5th of June 2022. And we as a team, this is a personal pledge. We as a team, what we have done is, we have taken a pledge of 1,000 sapling plantation, in 10 different cities within our team. Now, in this world, how do we do it? How do I do this, this job in one single day? That was a problem statement that came from all of us to my own team. And that's where we came into, came with a very innovative idea of what we call as a seed paper. So we really printed our one key message on this seed paper. This is a paper which has got a seed embedded into it, which is printable on an Indigo. We have printed it on an Indigo. We have sent it to 1,000 customers, the brand agencies, as well as the influencers or bloggers. And we are requesting them to plant that paper after, the message is read. So this is how we have done it. And this is what we are presenting it to the whole of the creative team today, is that if you have any requirement, please come back to us and we would be happy to be collaborating with you and really giving the right experience to the brand and to the consumer. With this, I end my presentation and I thank all of you for your patience listening. Thank you so much, audience, and back to you, Sanya.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ashok Pawar. It was a very, very insightful session. I took some notes myself. And with this note, we come to the end of our session. It was a very insightful session. We learned a lot. There were things about design, strategy, communication. And I hope everybody enjoyed this session as much as we enjoyed putting it up for you. We thank you all for joining and hope to see you in future sessions. Thank you.
Sure. Right. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Take care.